One of the biggest projects under construction in Europe, a floating and coastal highway in the deep waters of one of the most important countries that pay great attention to green transition and the environment. This country is Norway, a highly enduring and fascinating project with a budget of $47 billion, while it seems impossible. However, the developer of this project strongly believes that this project will be built. But how will they make this possible? Norway is a country that has a high environmental performance and strong commitment to green growth. According to the OECD environmental performance reviews, Norway is a front runner in many environmental areas and invests heavily in technological development and innovation to support its green transition. In this direction, they began to build the highway. The Norway Floating Coastal Highway is a massive infrastructure project that aims to connect the western coast of Norway by replacing the current ferry crossing with bridges, tunnels, and submerged floating tube bridges. The project is expected to cost about $47 billion and be completed by 2050. The project will also improve the accessibility and economic development of coastal regions. The floating highway is considered a world first in the engineering and innovation, as it will overcome the challenges of building across the deep and wide fjords. The story of the floating highway project goes back to the 19th century, when a British engineer named Sir Edward Reed proposed a submerged tube bridge across the English Channel. Edward Reed, a leading naval architect known for building a ship used by the Japanese Imperial Navy in the Meiji period, was the first to come up with the idea, and it was again proposed in 1923. However, then, much like in the 1800s, the technology simply didn't exist to make it possible. The idea of the floating highway in Norway was first suggested in 2011 when the Norwegian Public Roads Administration launched a feasibility study for the coastal highway Road E39 project. The MPRA also collaborated with universities, researchers and engineers from Norway and abroad to develop and test the innovative solutions for crossing the deep and wide fjords. The construction of the floating highway began in 2018, with the first phase began in Rogaland Fixing or Rogfast. Main reasons why Norway wants to build the floating highway project are to reduce the travel time between the cities of Kristiansund and Trondheim from 21 hours to 10 hours or less, and then to overcome the challenges of building across the deep and wide fjord with the innovative engineering solutions. If you have enjoyed the video so far, be sure to like the video. Norway Highway Project will change the routes of the coastal highway Road E39, which connects the cities of the Kristiansund and Trondheim along the western coast of Norway. The project will replace 7 ferry crossings with bridges, tunnels and submerged floating tube bridges. The routes that will change are Kristiansund-Mandal. This road will have a new 4-lane motorway that bypasses the current road and reduces the travel time by 20 minutes. Mandal-Lindal. This road will reduce the travel time by 15 minutes. Lindal-Flekkefjord. This road will reduce the travel time by 20 minutes. Flekkefjord-Sandal. Also, this road will reduce the travel time by 20 minutes. Sander-Stavanger. This road will have a new 27-kilometer long tunnel called Rogfast, which will be the world's longest and deepest road tunnel. It will have a maximum depth of 392 meters below sea level. The construction of tunnel started in 2018 and is expected to complete it by 2026, and it will reduce the travel time by 14 minutes. In Stavanger-Bergen, this road will have two new SFTPs that will cross the Bjørnfjord and Hogsfjord. They will reduce the travel time by 15 minutes. Bergen-Volda, this road will have a new bridge that will cross the Nordfjord. It will reduce the travel time by 15 minutes and eliminate the ferry crossing between Anda and Lo. Volda Molde. This route will have a new SFDB that will cross the Romsdal Fjord. It will reduce the travel time by 40 minutes. Molde Kristiansund. This route will have a new bridge that will cross the Free Fjord. It will reduce the travel time by 10 minutes. What do you think? Can the Norwegian Highway project be one of the biggest mega projects in Europe or not? Be sure to write it in the comments below. The floating highway will reduce the noise and air pollution from the ferry crossing, which can disrupt the marine mammals and birds. Also will create artificial habitats for fish and other marine organisms, as the bridge, tunnels and SFDBs will provide shelter, food and protection. But the floating highway will affect the water flow and circulation. Structure will have two parallel tubes connected every 250 meters with the emergency exit. They will also have lay-bys, phones, cameras and ventilation system along the road. The projects will reduce the congestion and waiting time for the ships that use the ferry crossing, as they will have more space and priority to pass and improve the safety and reliability of the shipping roads. It will be one of the hardest projects in Norway. We hope that this project will be successfully built with the proper management, and to find out about the next news and videos of these projects and other projects, subscribe to our channel and open the bell on the side and continue with another mega project.